opportunity. He sees everything you ever wanted. One moment that you captured, just let it slip. Yo.
His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now.
So, 2 months from independence, the day Tony Cairo sold out. I'm gonna break kayfabe here just because I can. Tony Cairo slapped everybody in the back, in the face, when he, right here, laid down to RFS. By the way, the new meaning is Rick fucking sucks. He laid down for the 1-2-3. How do I know? This ain't a conspiracy theory. This is the God's honest truth. I'd say about a minute before we go out there, maybe a couple of minutes, we got RFS in the back coming to me, Mr. Nagy, the franchise, Tony Cairo, saying that if Tony Cairo doesn't win the match, he's gonna make him win. What does that mean? In my personal opinion, which is the same as everybody else's, this was a pre-planned ordeal. This was all set up long before independence even was mentioned. So I'm gonna take you during the match. Mr. Nagy, the first to get pinned, no surprise. Second, the franchise gets pinned. That leaves me to carry Tony Cairo, like always. What did I do for 6 months? I carried his ass. Please. My God. Anyways, that's besides the point. So, me and Tony are the last two left. Tony hits the chiropractor, and I'm laid out, right? Tony goes and makes the cover. What's he saying to me? Kick out. Kick out. Kick out. Why in the hell is he telling me to kick out? Is it because he knew something was going to happen and he felt bad? Is it because he knew something was going to happen and he knew if he let it happen, everybody in the back would beat the fuck out of him? Tony Cairo don't realize it yet, but he's got a bullseye on his forehead the size of Texas. Everybody wants his ass. I want his ass. And they ain't got nothing to do with wrestling. It's personal now. And I'm not out here trying to plot out a new storyline or a new angle or a new feud. It's personal, Tony Cairo. And you will get yours tonight. Today, tonight, whatever the hell you want to call it. Moving right along to my favorite person in the whole wide world. Somebody who I personally, when the cameras aren't on, can't stand. Mr. Nagy, or as I like to call him, Mr. Gaggy, because he'll have any opportunity to suck your dick if you give it to him. As long as you'll make his show better, he'll suck your dick. Ask RFS. Hell, you could even ask Tony Cairo. I'm sure he's gone down south on Rick too. Right here, of course, at Independence, since that's the show that everyone's talking about, Mr. Nagy, standing face to face with me, said, shake my hand. I said, I'm gonna knock you out. He said, no, shake my hand. So what was I to do? I was forced to shake his
I forced you to shake my hand, and you know what? You did it because you knew it was in the best interest of your career. See, when it boils right down to it, Brian Denny, I made you. I gave you the opportunity to get in this ring each and every week. Without me, hey, just like you in HCW, it'd be done.
Don't go there, punk ass.
Hey, hey. You know it's true.
You know it's true. Shut up.
Hey, see the smile on my face? You know it's true. If I wouldn't have called you and we wouldn't have had that show on March 25th, what would you be doing right now? Sitting at home, doing jack shit? I gave you the opportunity, a second run at it. And I gave you your title. I gave you more opportunities than any other person. Okay? Even more opportunities than you gave yourself at HCW.
You know what? You see, you're such a big man as you claim. Who really got fucked at Independence? Who really did? And you know what? Fuck it.